Hey, Brianna. You know, thanks again for trying to help us get Sarah a gift this year, but sorry it didn't really work out in the end.
Oh, yeah, it's totally fine. It was no trouble at all. I mean, at least you didn't try to steal something.
Steal something? That's oddly specific. Why would you mention that?
Well, I mean, hey, most Christmas songs are actually just really old tunes where people sing new lyrics on top of them.
Is that like the thing hip-hop artists do, where they take music from someone else and then claim it's their own?
Well, not really. I mean, for example, take the ubiquitous Christmas carol, What Child Is This? That is actually just new lyrics sung over one of the oldest secular tunes in history, Green Sleeves.
Green Sleeves? What is that? The climate change reference? The one that we always try to fit into our shows?
No. I'm trying to be serious here. Does everything have to be a joke? Can't we just have one nice educational moment without going for the laughs?
Whoa. Hey, what are you doing here? Looking like that.
Oh, I'm just on my way to work. I tend the tavern at the old inn just up there.
Oh, what do you do for work? And what is that in your hand?
This, it's just a very old, very expensive violin.
Oh, that's pretty cool. Yeah.
I bet you sound amazing. Why don't you play something for us before you go?
Well, I don't have a public permit, and it draws a lot of attention to me, so I'd really rather just go.
Come on, please, just one, please. It won't be too big.
Well, all right, but then I really have to get going.
All right.
Thank you. Great, but I think next time we should stick to more conventional music.
Well, you know, I thought like our comedy was on point. I really like slapstick a lot, but you know,
yeah,
it's
slapstick
just me.
Humor is great.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And those are jingle bells, so that's something too.
For sure.
For sure. You know.
What should we name it?
Which one? This one?
Jonathan.
Jonathan, what about that one?
Jeffrey?
I was thinking Jeffrey? More along the lines of Carol.
Carol.
Oh, that's a good one.
Carol
nice.
Of the Bells, right?
I got it, yeah.
How about Mary?
Hmm.
Mary?
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Holly?
Holly?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Jingle.
Jingle.
We already made that joke.
Oh.
Yeah, we did. You know, it's a real slap to the face, huh?
Oh.
Are you going to do it?
Oh, yes.
Are you
gonna
going to do it?
Yes.
Do it.
Ready?
Do it. Anymore.
Oh, okay. Well.
Well, we should probably head out now, so bye, anyway. Guys. Well, it's not the end of the show, but, you know, bye,
yeah,
guys.
Yeah, yeah.
Thank you. Hello, everyone. I am Bob Claus. And before we get started, I'd like to wish you all a happy little Christmas. Today's, we'll be doing a little painting for you all today, and it'll be a little bit different than our normal work. We have two students here. We have Joseph.
Kumusta?
And we have Sarah.
Salutations.
Right. And today's painting will be a little painting I like to call Snowed In. So let's get started, shall we? All right, well, we're gonna start here with a nice parallel floor. You want to make sure the proportions are right and the angles are exactly straight. That can be our floor for today. Actually, let me correct that. Oh no. All right. Well, that can be our floor for today. But also, we want to include a wall because we want to enclose our happy family that lives in here with warmth for the holidays. So, we'll draw a perfectly straight line down here. And then, give ourselves a nice little roof. We'll do a nice little roof right here. But make sure to do a little crisscross strokes for the snow, because that's how snow works. Crisscross snow. But before we get started with more, we're gonna dry our brushes, and make sure we dry our brushes ever so gently, all right? My apologies. Well, I may have just ripped a hole in our painting, but that's all right. Let me just dispose of that real quick. All right, well, what is a little holiday scene without a happy little window right here where we can see all the snow? Right, and make sure to draw your snow. Make sure to draw your snow, okay? Make sure to draw your snow ever so gently, okay? All right, and we have two more things that we would like to paint. We're gonna create a big tree. Perfect tree right here, perfect tree. And then the last thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna create some presents, right? The present is now. So therefore we have some beautiful presents under the tree. All right, well, this is your holiday masterpiece that we will have today. And of course, I condone happy little accidents, so thank you, thank you, thank you. Oh, thank you so much. All right, well, enough about my perfect work. Let's look at our students' work today.
All right, well, Mr. Bob Claus, I decided to expand a little on your suggestions, and this is what I got.
Wow. Okay. Well, that painting looks Jerry festive. I think that in Webster's dictionary, it would qualify as a gold work of art.
Thank All you. Right, well, it's an honor.
Thank you, Sarah. And next we have Joseph.
I drew snow.
Cut the music.
So,
Joey, the artistic integrity. I've never seen a painting more beautiful than this. Am I looking at it backwards, or is it the other side?
It, in fact, is double-sided because of its double meaning.
Well, that is twice the work, my friend. Mm. Mm-hmm. That is amazing. Extra credit for you.
Yeah,
well.
Thank you, sir.
That's so deep, Joey.
Yeah, the theme Snowden really spoke to me, so I just know.
Well, this has not a single happy little accident, which normally I don't condone, but I've never seen something this perfect.
Yeah, I was like, you can't really have a happy little accident if you don't even put anything on the canvas, so why take the risk?
Well, exactly, my friend. Well, to everybody here, happy holidays, and I wish you happy paintings. Good night, everybody.
Of Hadley, fa la 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 la.
Hey, Alex, want to hear a song I wrote?
Sure.
Right, a song?
Here it goes.
Okay.
Decorate the corridors with lots of stuff. Put it on the walls and deck the halls. It's time for holiday cheer and stuff. Blah, 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 blah. Insert rhyme here.
Okay. I don't see... Might have gotten a little bit wrong there, or, I don't know, all of it?
I mean, hey, at least his tone was good. But Joey, in all honesty, that was not deck the halls. More like wreck the halls.
Ha ha ha, so funny. Well, you know, it was actually intentionally wrong. See, I printed out these holiday Mad Lib song sheets, and I decided to try one out. Except for whatever reason, the one I tried was just one really long blank, and all it said was, write a song. So that's what I did.
Let me see that, Joey. This doesn't say write a song. This is a grocery list, Joey. And instead of write a song, it says, buy a thong? Why is there a thong on your grocery list, Joey?
Don't worry about that.
All right, well, do we have any, like, actual Mad Lib sheets, or just sheets that aren't blank, or aren't a grocery list, or just aren't bad?
Okay, ouch, and yeah, I actually got a couple right here, so let's see if we can find one we like.
All right.
What do we want to do?
Oh, that was nice.
Yeah, that good.
All right, so you want to start us off here?
Sure. Can we get a name?
Brad.
All right. And another name?
Another name.
Another name.
Jerry. Nice choice.
With an I or with a Y?
The correct way, Joey.
All right. Okay.
An animal.
Animal.
Panda?
Panda.
Ooh,
panda.
Cute.
A color? Orange. Those are normal colors. Gold.
Gold.
Okay, gold. Right. Gold.
Now, can we have another animal? One at a time, please. Giraffe.
Giraffe.
I like
giraffe.
That.
I don't know how to spell giraffe.
Oh, Joey. Now, can we have an adjective, please?
Moist.
Moist. Did I hear moist?
I heard moist.
Oh.
Is that a cat? Can we get an animal, plural?
Hedgehog? Oh, geese. Hedgehog?
Geese.
And next, a verb.
Verb.
Please, a verb.
Running?
Run.
Run.
I think we got that yesterday, too. Mm. Seems popular.
Can we get another adjective?
We already have
a different,
adjective.
Originality, please.
Frilly? Let's go with frilly.
Frilly.
I don't know if I heard that right, but it's a nice adjective.
What's next? Another adjective.
But this time, make it weather related.
Stormy?
Mix it up.
Stop saying moist.
Should we just put that? Let's just put that.
Why don't we put mild? I think I heard
mild.
Yeah, mild.
Mild.
That's pretty similar to it, wouldn't you say? Can we just write moist?
Okay, we're writing
come
moist.
On,
okay,
come
we'll
on.
Do
what,
it.
What? Fine. All right, next, can we have a body part, please?
Toe.
Nice one.
Oh, God.
All right. Can we get a noun?
Clown.
That's
clown.
Good.
Clown.
Clown.
Okay.
Yeah. And next, an animal, please. Plural.
Plural animal.
Meerkats. I think I like meerkats. And next, can we have a verb, past tense?
Ran. We have run earlier.
Slept? Did I hear slept? Okay, I guess we'll go
slept. Okay, whatever.
Okay.
And
another color. Last one. Color.
Indigo.
Okay.
Cool. All right. Are we ready?
Yes.
Okay.
The song you guys created.
Should we just sing it together?
Okay. You know Dasher and Brad and Prancer and Vixen. Comet and Jerry and Donner and Blitzen. But do you recall the most famous panda of all?
Rudolph the gold-nosed giraffe had a very moist nose. And if you ever saw him,
You would even say it glows.
All of the other geese used to run and call him names. They never let poor Rudolph join in any frilly games.
Then one moist Christmas Eve, Santa came to say, Rudolph, with your toe so bright, won't you guide my clown tonight?
Then how the meerkats loved him,
and they slept out with glee. Rudolph the Indigo Ghost Reindeer, you'll go down in history.
Good job, guys.
Thank you. Thank you.
All right. But I think now we should go for some real music. What do you guys say?
Yeah.
Joey, have you seen Sarah anywhere?
No. She was just in the last transition.
What the heck?
Sarah? Is that you?
Nay.
Okay, what are you doing?
And can you stop?
Oh, it's backwards! Oh, my God. Oh. Quit horsing around! But like we asked you, what are you doing, Sarah?
I'm Rudolph. Can't you tell?
You're Rudolph?
Rudolph? Okay, well, why are you Rudolph?
I mean, I figured since we're still trying to figure out what makes the holidays so special, you know, like, Rudolph ended up pretty happy, so I decided to give it a try.
Hmm. All right, well how does this one
I mean,
go?
Like, okay, we did the Mad Libs, but, like, what's the real version of it?
Yeah. All of the other reindeer, you should call him names. They never left for Rudolph. Bless you. Joining any reindeer games.
Reindeer games.
Reindeer games.
What is a reindeer game?
Yeah, what constitutes a reindeer game?
Well, soccer, ultimate frisbee, basketball, hopscotch, you know, the usual.
Ultimate frisbee? How do you even play any of those when you have, you know, hooves?
Hmm. All right. Well, why not give it a shot, huh?
Okay. Luckily, we have exactly those sports right here. Let's start with basketball.
Sure.
Okay.
Yeah.
Just put these down. All right.
Hey, man, who's that cat coming down the street?
I don't know, but it sounds to me like that different man with the bone.
You're having yourself a ball.
All right, move it. Takes it down the court. He's dribbling very, very good. And oh, backwards pass. All right.
I don't think she can see. Her eyes are like that.
All right, well, maybe we should try a different game, huh?
Yeah. Oh, I missed. Oh, no.
Oh, pardon me, sir.
Thank you. I think that's a foul. Sorry.
All right, well.
15-yard foul?
Maybe ultimate frisbee?
Right. Go! Right. Not again!
Thank you!
Thank you so much!
Okay, final point. We gotta simulate the clutch, huh? Okay. Pass it to Joey.
Spin around in a circle! Another circle! Jump over to Alex again!
Alright, well, maybe one final score. I don't know if Frisbee's working either.
Whatever that ball is.
Okay, let's just call it soccer. Okay.
Oh my god!
Oh no, man.
The piano right there. Guys, I don't know the regulation for this.
Quit horsing around, Joey.
Okay.
Guys, I don't know if it's my heart or the Christmas spirit, but something's about to burst.
Thank you.
despite whatever happened last transition, I think I finally know what I want for the holidays, guys.
Oh, sure. What is it, Joey?
Oh, it's, you know, nothing too big. Just iPhones and AirPods, unlimited streaming, PCs and laptops with screens that are gleaming, Hulu and Netflix and Disney Plus. These are the gifts that I think are a must.
Hold up. Why would you need a subscription to Hulu? You really are part of Gen Z, aren't you?
Ow. Yeah.
Well, personally, I'm more worried about the pricing of all of that because I think the strategy that you need to take is either go into the store and then you need to look for discounts and coupons and Black Friday deals, gift cards and fruitcakes are all such a steal, re-gifts from last year all tied up in string. These are a few of my miserly things.
Oh my gosh, you guys are out of control. I mean, personally, besides getting me as a gift this year, I really think, like, I don't know, gifts should be more simple, you know, more like warm cookies, baking, and candles and windows. I don't know my line, but oh well, so it goes. Laughing with friends, hot cocoa in hand, true holiday gifts as I understand.
Wow, that was pretty profound, and actually I think you summed up the holiday spirit pretty well.
Thank you.
Yeah. Well, now that we're all feeling really chummy right now, I think that we can end this in the most cliche way possible. Let's have an audience sing along, so if you know the words, then sing along.
Raindrops on roses and whiskers on kittens, bright copper kettles and warm woolen mittens, brown paper packages tied up in string. These are a few of my favorite things.
All right, thank you. Yes. Now, despite how cliche that was, it really taught us the spirit of togetherness, and you know, maybe you were right, Alex. Maybe something like a holiday miracle can happen.
Well, I don't think what I can say can be any chatter than what you just said, but don't you think he's getting a little cheesy?
Yeah, hold on. I think something mysteriously just appeared in my back pocket. Oh god, it's another letter from USC.
Oh,
like,
shoot.
Do they have to keep rubbing it in? Anyway,
let's
just see. Dear Joey, lol JK, you made it in? It appears you have indeed passed the vibe check and now are attending University of Santa Claus, the Carol. Did I just get into college?
Joey's just gotten to college, everybody!
To college? Yeah!
Let's go!
Alex! Okay, you know how we end a movie? Freeze frame.
Yeah, freeze frame.
Freeze frame. So, Alex, we're nearing the end of our show, and you know what time it is?
It's time to reflect on the plot and realize the journey that our protagonists have gone through.
Here.
Exactly. So, what have we learned on this journey of ours?
Well, we've learned the spirit of giving. If by giving we learn that not to give gifts to people that are themselves.
Mm-hmm. The gift of togetherness, obviously, from that wonderful number we sung earlier.
Yeah, and I guess the spirit of warm weather, right? Even though it's 70 degrees and we found out that more layers doesn't work.
Yeah. With all that learned, it still feels like we're missing just a little something extra. Holiday infomercials! Have you ever wondered, my mug is too small?
Why yes, Joseph. I have wondered that.
Are you so tired of drinking only regular-sized amounts of any beverage you like?
Indeed I have.
Well, introducing the Mega Mug! All the fun and none of the practicality of your normal mug. Simply take out your Mega Mug, fill all 5 gallons of its capacity with any of your favorite beverage, and there you go.
Well, Joey, before this holiday, I felt so empty. I felt I couldn't handle the holidays without a great gift. Orange, you glad you got this product for me?
Whoa. Yes, take a sip, sir, take a sip.
It feels good.
That's great.
Really good.
Don't worry about that. Did it taste good?
That tasted very good.
Well, in case it doesn't taste good, and your drink happens to get slightly cool, we will throw in our patented Mega Mug Mitten Warmer. Like, we're actually going to literally throw it in your drink. And now it is warm, fuzzy, and probably inedible.
Are you tired of snow falling on you every winter?
I hate snow.
Can you not stand it?
But we live in San Diego.
Well, Joseph, I know you're feeling down about that.
Mm-hmm.
But do I have the product for you? Wow, it's the Snow Repeller 2000. Whoa! Wear it like an umbrella, and it stands the test of the weather. Well, it blocks 10% of all of snow from falling on you. And you might be thinking to yourself, wow, that's not a lot of percent. Well, that'll teach you optimism, because 10% is better than zero.
But what if I'm satisfied with just 10%?
Well, I know what you're asking me. Why are you doing this? This is a wire if you can't see, but yeah, it's a wire. Well, you can pay $40 for more coverage if you're not satisfied with all of that.
Wow. Let's change the channel, Alex. Let me ask you all a question. Are you tired?
No, I am not tired. I am Alex.
Well, if you're tired, I have the cure for your tiredness. Introducing Constant Caroling. A small, compact device that has stored on it all of your least favorite holiday carols. They are also out of tune and out of time. Simply apply them to your head, turn it on the only volume setting,
really loud,
and enjoy sleepless nights. It's really working! I think they're playing Carol of the Bell right now.
How much does it cost, Joey?
What?
How much does it cost,
what?
Joey?
Oh! $15.99 plus shipping and handling. And if you order right now, we'll throw in another min!
Wow. Well, with all of these products that we have right here, you'll have this holiday season in the bag.
What? What?
Thank you.
Well, we'd like to thank you all for coming out here tonight.
Just have a happy holidays, everyone. Drive safe, and
have a wonderful holiday season.
See you in the spring.